Maybe you haven't seen this before, but definitely check this out because this is going to be really, really cool. So first of all, I want to start off with a triangle with an angle to be 36 degrees and then two of the sides to be the same, all right? And hopefully my picture looks okay right here. So I will put down the 36 degree angle right here. I don't want the angle to be 18 yet, all right? I want this angle to be 36 degrees. And I want these two sides to be the same. And the easiest number for me to consider, it will be just 1 and 1. I can totally do this because I'm constructing the triangle. Because these two sides are the same, we know that once I connect the third side, which is right here, these two angles will be the same as well, right? And of course, we can just go ahead and do 180 minus 36, which is 144, and then divide it by 2. That means we can get this to be 72 degrees. Likewise, this will also be 72 degrees. And of course, that will be the isosceles triangle, which is pretty right here. And now, ideally speaking, if I can figure out what this side is, I will actually be done. Because even though this is not a right triangle, the moment I cut this right into the middle, I will get the 18, 72, 90 special right triangle for you guys, right? So I really want to figure out how long this is. And now let me get a quote from my subscriber right here, which he says that the greatest trick in mathematics is that whenever we don't know something, we are just going to go ahead and call that to be x. So right here, because I don't know what this is, let me just go ahead and say this is x right here. Okay? And now, what else can we do? Well, as we discussed earlier, I'm going to cut this triangle right in the middle like this in a minute, right? That's how we can get the 18 degrees. But what if I decided to cut this right here, right in the middle as well? Let's see, what do we get? Here we have 72 degrees. Notice when I cut this right in the middle like this, we get what? This angle, which is going to be half of 72, and that's going to be 36 degrees, right? And more importantly, this side will be what? Will also be x, isn't it? Because, you see, we have 36 degrees right here. This is 72. And you know this angle, it's also going to be 72 degrees, right? Because, in fact, the triangle that I have in red, right, almost in red, this right here is similar to the original triangle. This is so cool. And now let me draw the red triangle on the side for you guys. So right here, you see x and x. Let me just put this down right here, x and x. And this right here, I'll just keep in black, which I don't know what it is yet. And you see, this angle was the 36 degrees, and then these two angles are still 72 degrees, right? So let me just indicate that 72 degrees here, likewise 72 degrees here. These two triangles are indeed similar because all the angles are the same, isn't it? And now, what else can we do from here? If you look back to the triangle in black right here, we have 1, 1, and x. Right here, we have x, x, and this right here, I don't know. But remember, this piece comes from here, right? What other information can we put down, though? Check this out. Here is the beauty of using 36, 72, and 72. Because the moment that we cut this into half, here we get 36. Likewise, here we also have 36 degrees, right? And check this out. This is 36. That's also 36. Once again, these two angles are the same. That means these two sides will be the same, isn't it? Here is x. That means this side will also be x, isn't it? So now, I'll put this down in blue. This right here, it's also x, okay? Even though my picture is not perfect, but trust the number, trust the math, all right? Believe in the math. I'm not using Wolfram alpha in this case, so just believe in the math. Okay, so here is x. Remember, the whole thing is 1. I know this much is x already, so how big is this? Let me just do this in black as well. Well, do this in blue, why not? How big is this? The whole thing is 1, this is x, so I know this right here has to be 1 minus x, isn't it? This is blue, by the way. This is 1 minus x. Okay, now, you know this piece, it's the same as that, so you must have this piece right here being 1 minus x as well. So, we have two similar triangles, what can we do? We can solve this by setting up proportion, isn't it? And I will just go ahead and do that for you guys. Depends on how you want to do it. As long as you do it consistently, you will be okay. So we set up a proportion. I will just do this side over that side, namely x over 1, okay? We must have x over 1 from here to here. It has to be this over that, okay? So 1 minus x over x. Once again, this over that. So we have the 1 minus x over that x. And that's the equation that we have. Of course, you can just go ahead and solve the equation. You can cross multiply if you would like. So this is going to be x squared, and then that will be equal to 1 times that, which is 1 minus x. Put everything on one side. So you have x squared plus x minus 1 is equal to 0. And now what? Quadratic equation, isn't it? So you go ahead and say this is x equal to negative b, which is 1, so you have negative 1, like this, plus minus square root of b squared, which is 1 squared, minus 4ac, a is 1, and c is negative 1, and this is what we have inside, all over 2 times a, which is 1, all right? So that's what we have, all right? And you will notice, okay, we have negative 1, plus minus, no problem at the moment. Open the square root and check this out. 1 squared is 1. Minus times minus is plus. And 4 times 1 times 1, just numbers-wise, it's 4. Altogether, it's 1 plus 4, which is 5. So inside, it's 5 over 2 times 1, which is, of course, just a 2. We have 2 answers for x, but only 1 makes sense, because we are talking about triangles. If you have negative 1 minus square root of 5, it doesn't make sense, because this right here will give us a negative result. We cannot have a negative side in a triangle, right? So we are going to ignore the negative, so only consider x equal to negative 1 plus square root of 5 over 2. What is this? This is x, which is the same as that. And now I'm just going to draw that picture again. So the same picture over there, which is like this. Put this down in red. This right here is a 36, but let me not do that. Actually, well, why not? Let me just do that. 36 degrees, 72 degrees, 72 degrees. This right here is that, which is negative 1 plus square root of 5 over 2. This side is 1, that side is 1, because I got it from there. Now what? As I said earlier, I will cut this right in the middle. So now, cut this right in the middle. This is my 90 degree. And now, check this out. I don't know what this is. You could figure it out by using the Pythagorean theorem, or do sine, cosine, whatever you would like, right? Okay. I will have this triangle here. This is right here, which is now 18 degrees. And this side is still equal to 1. And right here, this is half of the whole thing earlier. So instead of dividing by 2 only, we will have to divide this by 4 altogether, right? So altogether, you have negative 1 plus square root of 5 over 4. Because this is just half that. So it's not just over 2, it's actually over 4. And you have the 70 62 degrees right here. And here you have it. This is almost the complete version of the 1872-90 special right triangle. Well, from here, you can go ahead and do sine of 18 degrees. How do we do that? Here is the 18 degrees. You can go ahead and say that's the opposite, which is right here, which is this. Negative 1 plus square root of 5 over 4. Right, that's the opposite side. Over the hypotenuse, which is over 1. Right? Of course, the over 1 doesn't matter. So, ladies and gentlemen, let me just write this down finally for you guys. Sine of 18 degrees equal to just that, which is negative 1 plus square root of 5 all over 4. And I know somebody is about to comment down below and tell me what this number is related to the golden ratio, right? This is so cool, so amazing, so much fun. And as usual, that is it.